Have you ever heard about real-time path tracing? By the end of this video, you'll know how real-time path tracing works and whether it's ready for professional workflows. Path tracing is a rendering technique that realistically simulates how the light interacts with surfaces, creating highly detailed shadows, reflections, and global illumination. It results in a need for a lot of computing power to mimic all of these behaviors. Unlike other methods like rasterization or basic ray tracing, leading to realistic visuals. Traditionally, path tracing was too slow for anything but pre-rendered content, requiring massive computing power. However, with modern GPUs and dedicated ray tracing hardware, it's making its way into real-time applications. Real-time path tracing still requires optimization, often blending with rasterization to maintain performance. Games, for example, typically use it for specific effects like realistic lighting or reflections, while relying on faster techniques for the rest of the scene. As hardware advances, real-time path tracing is getting closer to delivering fully cinematic visuals in interactive experiences. In the new version of DeFi 2.10, we can take advantage of real-time path tracing. Built on the Raster GI framework, this approach uses path tracing to construct light caches, pushing real-time global illumination closer to ground truth results. It significantly enhances the realism and immersive quality of real-time interactions. We can observe, for example, improvement in GI accuracy. We can observe it in a scene with a metallic floor. In comparison to version 2.9, we would see the surface with incorrect reflections, often appearing dark or inconsistent. In version 2.10, the metallic floor accurately renders its reflective properties in the preview window, providing more realistic results. Another thing worth mentioning is the GI bounce details that result in more accurate rendering of light and shadow details. As a result, the contact points between walls and floors or between furniture and the ground are rendered with higher precision. So, for example, furniture surfaces such as sofas and cabinets now display more accurate light and shadow transitions, improving the perception of depth and realism. To turn on the new algorithm, we have to go to Menu, Preferences, Rendering, and then enable the real-time tracing option. Thanks to that, the software automatically knows that we want to use this method. If we turn it off, it will go back to the GI solutions used in the previous version, 2.9. As we have the real-time path tracing on, you can find new custom settings in the Display tab. You can see the Accumulate button. Alternatively, use F4 on your keyboard to turn it on. When we turn it on, the viewport enters a static mode, where the image continuously refines over time, progressively approaching the final output quality. If you go down, you can see we have three options, where we can change settings. GI precision, where we have three precision levels. The lower the level, the faster the accumulation. The higher the level, the more precise the GI quality. In complex interior scenes, where natural light needs to bounce multiple times to illuminate deeper areas, increasing the precision produces more accurate and brighter results. You can see that a GI precision of 3 produces a significantly better result compared to a precision of 1. We have a separate setting that controls GI for reflections, reflection depth. It improves the accuracy of reflections in highly reflective materials, and it controls the number of times rays bounce between highly reflective material surfaces. In scenes with reflective surfaces, such as a metallic floor with a reflective surface, increasing the reflection depth from 1 to 3 enhances the detail and accuracy of the reflections. Version 2.2 also supports real-time previews of mirror-like reflections, which is particularly useful for scenes such as bathrooms with mirrors or glass-clad buildings. And finally, the SPP. It determines the number of times each pixel is sampled, affecting the accuracy of light and shadow details. Increasing the value helps optimize artifacts in challenging areas and enhances details, but will also increase the rendering time. In scenarios with challenging lighting conditions, such as a room illuminated by a small skylight, a low sample count may result in smudged or imprecise shadow details. In this case, increasing the sample count resolves these issues, producing sharper and more accurate results. You should be aware that these custom parameters affect both image and video rendering quality, as well as speed. In most cases, it's not necessary to set everything to full. For example, 64 SSP is usually sufficient. The settings for GI precision and reflection depth can be adjusted based on specific project needs. So I would advise to confirm parameter settings before rendering final outputs when custom options are enabled. If you tested your scene and want to send the render to final, you do it exactly the same as you would in previous versions. The only thing you would notice are longer rendering times, but it comes with better quality, of course. To give you an idea of rendering times, let me show you a couple of examples. For this bathroom scene with the highest custom parameters, the 4K image was rendered around 17 minutes, in comparison to the previous version that rendered 51 seconds. It's a difference, but with the quality we get, with the higher precision of GI and reflections, it's not a big deal to wait less than 20 minutes for the render. You still have an option to go back to ultra super speed. Another example is this scene. The render with full settings took 1 hour and 20 minutes, while it took less than 6 minutes with low settings. But look how more detailed and accurate the scene is with high settings. Nice! And it's still way faster than rendering with V-Ray or Corona. In general, we can notice that in close interior spaces with little to no external light, D5 tends to perform particularly well. What does it mean for us? We can get a great balance between quality images and the speed. Here is the D5 render with full settings. It took around 1 hour and 15 minutes to render. We need to agree that the quality is impressive. For comparison, I will show you the same image for the previous version that took only 1 minute. At first, you may think that the difference is not huge, but these details add so much realism to the image. Look at the materials and how the reflections look. It completely changed the bookshelf material. Or the wood. Look at these reflections. The curtain really looks great now. Look how the light changed. It was all thanks to the GI calculations, even the light's gradient. Look at the sofa. The shadows look different. They are softer, which makes it look more natural. Now, let's take a look at the V-Ray version. It took almost 3.5 hours to render a 4K image. That's almost 3 times more than D5. And the quality is very comparisonable. To be fair, I didn't change too much in 3ds Max scene. I imported the original file from SketchUp. Of course, I could spend more time adjusting the materials, lighting, and so on, but it's good enough to give you an idea for comparison. Of course, there are some details that still perform better in DCC tools, but it all depends on what you need. All in all, I think this new feature is fantastic news for all D5 users. Thanks to the new algorithm, we can get way better quality images and videos with still reasonable rendering times. As I said before, it's a great balance between quality and speed. D5 2.10 offers more cool options, like a city generator with OSM integration, AI motion blur, AI in painting, night sky with the option to add a moon and a Milky Way, and a huge asset library. So don't wait and check them all out. Bye bye!